What's going on, guys? Starting today's video off a little bit later today. I didn't get a chance to edit the video when I got back from legs last night because I got back and I crashed. I was so tired, so I just went to sleep. Got an early night, woke up early this morning to edit this video. Got my cardio done, got my food prepped, got everything done. My mate Scott came around earlier. We spoke about some business and like plans for the future and stuff. But right now, I'm about to have my pre-workout meal. I've got turkey mince, rice, and spinach. Then we're gonna head to the gym and train chest and triceps. Hope you guys enjoy the video. Till the day I die. Right now, I'm just watching some Louis Marco, and my mum is being the mum that she is, and she's deboning my card. There was a deal on at Morrison's, and it's like £6.55 for like literally like three servings. So it's like £2 a meal, which is even cheaper than I got at the fish market. But she's just deboning the fish right now, because I ain't got a clue how to do it. Four portions done. We'll probably get five portions from this because it weighs 225 kg more. So that's nine portions that'll last like 7 days. Right, so I'm just about to have my pre-workout meal. I have 180 grams of turkey mince, some spinach, and 55 grams, well, this is cooked, so it's 110 grams of Tilda Brown basmati rice. The reason it's 110 grams and not 55 grams is because when it's cooked, it doubles in weight. And especially if you use these packets, I don't always use these packets. This was kind of a last resort because I always cook my rice in the morning. But if you do happen to like, say like run out of like uncooked rice and you only have the chance to like have the packets, it doubles. In about an hour, 40 minutes-ish, we're going to the gym and we're training chest and triceps. It's going to be such a good workout. Chest and triceps is my favorite day. And this is day two of my new workout split, so it's going to be good. Right, so I'm just gonna eat this, have my BCAAs, and watch John Venus's new upload, Vegans Hate Keto Body. Keto Body's basically this guy that believes in intermediate fasting. He's a little bit cocky, and like his attitude towards like fitness and stuff is like, oh, if you eat six meals a day, like you're not gonna get big, you need to starve yourself and have two meals on a night time and you'll get big. For me, that doesn't make any sense, and if Jean Venus is about to say what I think he's gonna say, then I respect this guy. I mean, I respect Jean Venus anyway, like his video is crazy. He's got 68,000 subscribers now, he's a vegan, like he pushes veganism in the way that it should be pushed, not the way Vegan Gains pushes it, and Vegan Gains kind of like presses it on people, shows slaughter videos in like most of his videos and stuff. And I also know that Mike Diamond is currently doing the 1 week vegan challenge, and Bradley Martin did something to do with veganism, and everyone's just trying it for some reason. But for me, I don't think I'll be trying it. But I'm gonna watch this, eat this, drink this, and head to the gym.
Make a difference of building muscle. I build a huge amount of muscle on a vegan diet, and countless other people have done so as well.
I also got my BCAAs and my gym bag. Alright, see you later. Right, so pretty much just got to the gym. Today's workout is going to be a typical hypertrophy workout. Anywhere from 10 to 15 rep ranges. We're going to be doing chest and triceps, concentrating a lot on the eccentric part of the movement because we really want to get that squeeze, we want to get the blood into the muscles, we want to rip these muscles apart while I can. Not dealing with any heavy weights today because I want to get the reps out, like I said. Let's go. There's an IFBB, a NABBA. So I'm just walking into the gym now. I'm probably gonna hit 5 exercises on chest and 4 exercises on triceps. So I'm just starting off today's session with some bench press. You should always start your workouts off with a compound movement. Personally, unless you wanna pre-exhaust your muscles, always start chest day with bench, back day with deadlifts, shoulders with, I guess you could do Arnold press, shoulder press, dumbbell press, barbell press, and then legs with squats, obviously. But yeah, chest, we did 20 reps with just a bar, 15 reps with one plate. Then we're gonna go 2 plates. Probably get around 6 to 8 reps now. I've got a lot weaker on bench now I'm prep. I used to be able to do like 10 reps with 100 kg, maybe even 12 reps, like for like 4 sets. But now it's a struggle for like 2 sets doing like 8 reps. But I'm gonna do what I can. Let's go. Right, so we just got done doing bench press, now we're going to do incline bench, dumbbell press. I prefer doing dumbbell press because I feel like bench press restricts you from going like past that point of like really stretching the muscle. I just prefer it. So we're going to start on 30kg, go 35kg, do a few reps on 40kg, then we'll drop the weight back down and get the reps out. So we just got done with the first two sets, now we're going on to 40kg and see how many reps we can get out for three sets. So we just got done doing incline dumbbell press, now we're going to pet that machine. We're going to really concentrate on the eccentric part of the movement, like really going out real slow and then bringing it together, but don't touch your fist at the top, because a lot of people, when they do, take their... when they do dumbbell flies, they kind of rest their fists together at the top and that completely takes the tension off your pecs. So you want to hover, just keep it there. We're going to do four sets of 15 reps. It's going to be hard, but it's going to be good. Loves me not, leave the flowers say to rot and die. He used to look so bright, but you took the stars from my eyes. What's going on, guys? I thought I'd do a commentary over this part of the video because I really want to talk about something, and that is how to perform a closed grip bench press properly. Now, a lot of people make some mistakes in this. They either put their hands too wide and they don't interpret enough of their tricep, which actually activates too much of the chest, or they put their hands too close, which will result in pain in the wrist, elbow, and sometimes front delt. Now, the way to overcome this is I found that if you put your hands around 8 to 10 inches apart, as you can see in the video, which personally I found activates the most amount of my tricep with the least amount of chest and the least amount of joint pain. But everyone's different. Some people can definitely go a lot closer if they want to, if they feel it more on their tricep. Like, you don't necessarily have to put your hands 8 to 10 inches apart. It's just what I found works best for me. I got this off a Victor Martinez and Kai Green. It's like a 10-part workout video. I watched the whole thing. I can't believe I watched the whole thing. It took me like 2 hours. But I was having a lot of trouble with my wrists when I was close grip bench pressing. And I actually neglected close grip bench press for a long time because of how much it did hurt. But after being told and kind of like realizing that you didn't actually have to put your wrist so close, I enjoy close-up bench press a lot more, and I found that it's really benefited my triceps. But that's it for the commentary part of this video. I really hope some of you guys can take something away from that, because I know that if someone told me this when I first started training, I would have really benefited from it. But like I said, that's it for the commentary. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of the video. You know what I feel like vlogging's like? You ever played the game Mirror's Edge? You know, it's all like first-person free-running, like a free-running Japanese girl. I'm heading off this way, man.
Yeah,
right, see you in a bit. Yes, I may be chilling under a lamppost at 11 o'clock at night, but you gotta hit that anabolic window. If you don't hit that anabolic window, if you don't have that protein shake within half an hour to an hour finishing your workout, you won't make any gains. So you gotta do what must be done. This thing was just on the floor. Extra protein.
Right, so I got back from the gym a little bit over an hour ago. I had a meal. I had 180 grams of chicken breast with 50 grams of basmati rice. Right now, I'm about to cook my meal for after cardio, which is 225 grams of cod, 220 grams of sweet potato, and some more spinach. But you know, we might spice things up and have some green beans too. But right now, I'm having a little bit of a problem. See, I don't like to cook fish in the frying pan because I can barely cook chicken and always burn it. And fish is a lot more delicate, so it'll be black basically. Like, I'm not even gonna attempt it. So I usually cook it in the microwave to be safe, but I can't do that today because we don't have any more cling film or tinfoil to like put over the dish that I cook the fish in. So we're gonna have to improvise.
So basically, you know these takeaway tins? Well, we have a few in that drawer. And I also have freezer bags. So I'm thinking about putting the fish in this and then putting it in the freezer bag, sellotaping the freezer bag together and hoping that this cooks. And there's green beans everywhere. I've got to like fold the edges in so it fits in the bag. Now, I don't know if this is going to work, but I wouldn't try it yourself because this could like explode and go seriously wrong. But what else is there to do at 2 in the morning? And it goes 3 minutes. Let's hope for the best. The bag kind of exploded, but with that being said, I think the fish is cooked. Right guys, it's getting a little bit late now. I'm just watching a Steve Cook's new video, Time to Get Big. It's making me feel like I need to eat more than the cod and sweet potato. I might just hit the tub as well for the extra gains. But yes, I am watching YouTube videos at 3:30, but what are you gonna do? Yeah, like I said, I'm gonna watch this, eat this, and head off to bed. I've got an early morning start. I've got to do 20 minutes fasting cardio, get to the bank, put some money in the bank, and just prep my meals and start the day. So I think that's it for the video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share, comment. What else do you say? Share, like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys in the morning.